Hello, in this video we take a look at render layers and how to use them in compositing. For this tutorial I chose this scene, a Cardassian Galor class chases and fires upon a Klingon bird of prey. In the background we see an ice planet. When we leave the camera view and move the viewport around, you see that the planet is in HDRI. When we take a closer look at the outliner, we see that the objects are distributed in several collections. Each ship has its own collection, including individual sunlights, the disruptor shot and the explosion, and the camera. We want to separate the renders for each object because I want to apply a fog glow effect on the disruptor shot and the explosion, but not on the ships or the background. When we take a closer look to the background, you see the planet already has a fog glow effect. In the very upper right corner, you see the default render layer, view layer. Per default, every new collection is added to this view layer. I rename the view layer to Bird of Prey. Now we need to exclude the other collection from this render layer. The quick method is to uncheck exclude from view layer in the outliner. The long way is to right click on the collection, view layer, disable from view layer. Now we need to add a new render layer, click on the icon right next to the name and select new. I rename the new layer to shot. We exclude the bird of prey and the gala from this view layer. Add another view layer and rename it to Galore. Exclude the bird of prey and the shot layer. With the icon on the left to the name, we can switch between the layers. I switch back to the bird of prey and go to the view layer property tab. Scroll down to the subsection light, other, and activate environment. In the render settings, activate transparent in the film section. Now we are ready to render the scene. Hit F12. Switch to the compositing tab. Activate the option Use Nodes in the menu. Now Blender creates a render layer node, which is connected with the compositing node. If a node wrangler add-on is active, you can create a distribution node with Shift plus holding down the right mouse button and drag it over the connection. Add a viewer node and connect the distribution node with the viewer node. Duplicate the render layer and switch to the shot render layer. Duplicate once again and select the Galor layer. Since we activate the environment pass in the bird of prey layer, the output ENV is available in this node. First we need an alpha overnode. Press Shift A and type alpha. Blender filters all nodes with the alpha in the name. Select alpha over and plug the environment output into the first input and the Galor layer into the second. You should see the background and the Cardassian Galor class. We fill the black silhouette in one of the next steps. Duplicate the alpha over and connect the output of the first alpha over into the first input and the shot layer into the second input. For this layer, we want to add a fog glow effect. Shift A and go to Filter and choose the Glare node. Switch to Fog Glow and High Quality and increase the size to 9. Duplicate the alpha over for the last time and plug the image of a Bird of Prey node into the second input. And that's it for the glow effect and the usage of render layers. One last tip at the end. With our view layers active, we don't see the whole scene. Making adjustment can be quite difficult. But you can add an additional working layer with every collection visible. You can align the object in your scene and keep your render settings. And that's it for this video, and I will see you in the next one.